Now, an alternative proof that actually helps you remember this particular result, and you should remember this particular result because it is going to come up in our analyses of cost of various algorithms. Now notice that the sum from I equal to 0 to n minus 1 is equal to of I is equal to 0 plus 1 plus dot 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 plus n minus 2 plus n minus 1. And the sum from I equals 0 to n minus 1 is also equal to 0, this is a 2 here, plus 1 plus dot 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 plus n minus 2 plus n minus 1. If I add this to that, what I get is 2 times I equals 0 to n minus 1 of I. And if I add all of these to that, I can't add the individual terms here, corresponding terms here, and then add the result of those together. Now, adding this term to that term gives me n minus 1. Adding this term to that term gives me n minus 1. Adding this term to that term gives me n minus 1. Same thing here. Now, how many of these terms are there? N. So if I add them all together, I get n times n minus 1, which then is equal to 2 times the result of what I want. But if I then divide this side by 2 and then divide that side by 2, I get exactly the result that I want. So this is a nice way of remembering this result if you ever need it.